The question 3a, define by Oates-Roberts law, how it is useful to derive H, explain. This question is given for 7 marks, set number 1. So let us see how a static magnetic field is created. So a static magnetic field is created by a permanent magnet. A permanent magnet produces static magnetic field. Because the magnetic field is always from north pole to south pole. Now, for example, if you take a conductor, say this is a conductor, if it is carrying a DC current, capital I, it produces static magnetic field. Now, if you take a conductor, if it is carrying an alternating current, say Im sin omega t, it produces an electromagnetic field. So now let us see this second one. That means a DC current passing through a conductor produces a static magnetic field. So therefore, a magnetic field is produced around the current carrying conductor. From this, okay, now what is defined? Let us define what is Biot-Savart's law. Consider a current carrying conductor. Let us assume that a conductor which is carrying a current I, DC current I, let us call this is carrying a DC current I. So suppose it produces a magnetic field around it. We want to find out the magnetic field intensity DH at any point P. Take a small section on this conductor which is represented as IDL. Join this small section to the point P. It is represented as R. The distance between this element IDL and the point P is represented as R. Alpha is angle between this element and the line joining the element and the point. So from this, the Biot-Savart's law is defined as the magnetic field intensity DH at any point P due to a differential current element IDL is proportional to product of differential current element IDL and sine of angle alpha between element and line joining the element, line joining the element and the point, and the point, comma, and is inversely proportional to square of distance between them. So what is this DH? So now the magnetic field intensity DH is given by it is proportional to the product of, as per the definition of Biot-Savart's law, it is proportional to the product of differential current element and sine of angle alpha by inversely proportional to square of the distance between them. Now, so this is Biot-Savart's law. Now, if you remove the proportionality constant, it is written as, so IDL sine sine alpha by 4 pi r square. In SI units, the proportionality constant is 4 pi. It is written as dH is equal to IdL by 4 pi r square. Let us see what is its unit. It says the current unit is ampere, dl small section length is meter, and distance square meter square. So its unit is meter, meter square gets cancels out. Its unit is ampere per meter. So therefore, what is the magnetic field intensity unit? Its magnetic field intensity unit is ampere per meter. Now, by definition of cross product, by definition of cross product, by definition of cross product, so IdL sine alpha is written as IdL cross AR. So AR is the unit vector between the element and the point. Here AR is the unit vector between the element and the point, the unit vector. Now replace this IdL cross AR in this formula, so therefore dH, so that is differential magnetic field is written as IdL cross product with unit vector AR by 4 pi r square, the unit is ampere per meter. Now the direction of magnetic field is given by right hand thumb rule. The direction of magnetic field, if you take a conductor like this, if your conductor, it is carrying a current I, the magnetic field is in the form of circles around the current carrying conductor, so these are called as magnetic flux lines. So these lines are called as magnetic flux lines, the H is always tangential to these magnetic flux lines. The magnetic field intensity H is tangential to this magnetic flux path at everywhere, So these are the magnetic flux lines. These two are magnetic flux lines, The magnetic flux lines are always in the form of closed circles. The magnetic flux lines are always in the form of closed circles around the conductor. So the direction of magnetic field is given by right hand thumb rule. If the thumb, right thumb, is pointing in the direction of current, then the magnetic field, the fingers closing this conductor, will give the direction of magnetic field. What is right hand thumb rule? If the thumb is pointing the direction of current, then the fingers closing this conductor will indicate the direction of magnetic field. Now this is the formula which you use to calculate H from Biot-Savart. Suppose if the current is flowing in the form of a sheet, for example, instead of current flowing in a conductor, the current is flowing in a sheet, it is represented with surface current density. Its unit, it is represented with the letter K, that is current per unit width. What is current density? Current per unit width. Its unit is ampere per meter. Now, in this case, if a surface current is given, that is current flowing in a sheet, we have to take a small area on the sheet. The small area is represented as ds. For example, if the current is flowing in a volume, then it is represented with volume current density J. So current per unit area, that is its unit is ampere per meter square. In this case, if you take a small volume V, small volume dV, when volume current is given. So therefore, these are the two currents. So surface current, if the current is flowing in a sheet, it is represented with K, and if the current is flowing in a volume, it is represented with J. So now this Biot-Savart's law formula can be modified for surface current and volume current. This same expression is written as dH is equal to Idl cross Ar by 4 pi r square. So this formula we use in case of line current, that is current flowing in a conductor. This is formula used for line current. In place of Idl, you replace by KdS cross Ar by 4 pi r square. This formula you use in case of the current is given in the form of a sheet, a surface current or sheet current. So that is equal to KdS is replaced by JdV cross Ar by 4 pi r square in case of volume current is given. That is current flowing in a given volume. The current is flowing in a given volume. So these are the formulas which we have to use, in case of line current, in case of surface current or sheet current, in case of volume current is given to find out magnetic field intensity dH. So therefore, the total magnetic field intensity because of entire length of the conductor is given by Idl cross Ar by 4 pi r square. So this is in case of line current. In case of line current, this is the total magnetic field intensity because of entire length of the conductor. So that is equal to surface integration of Idl is replaced by KdS cross Ar by 4 pi r square. This formula you have to use if the current is given in the form of a sheet or surface current. We use this formula to calculate the total magnetic field intensity H, and we have to use this formula. KdS is replaced by JdV cross Ar by 4 pi r square. This we have to use in case of the current is given in the form of a volume current. If it is given, to find out H we have to use this formula. So this is the answer you have to write for this question to get 7 marks. Thank you.